Hey guys, have you heard of the little horn of Daniel chapter 7? So, as it appears, it's not as literal as it is. So, this is the kingdom. According to the Bible prophecy, there were to be four kingdoms. So, in the fourth one, which is Rome, that's where now we find the little horn. There's one with eyes and a mouth, but it has no ears. Are you curious? Okay, let's see what the Bible says about the little horn. Eh? And the Bible verse that we get is from Daniel chapter 7 verse 17. It tells us that the four beasts are the four kingdoms. Then on the fourth kingdom, that is the fourth kingdom that will appear on earth. It will be different from others. It will devour the whole earth. So what is this? It has 10 horns. The 10 horns are the 10 kings who will come from this kingdom. Then after them, another king will arise, different from the earlier ones. So from these 10 kings, now comes the literal horn, that we are saying it is not as literal as it appears. What about it? So, yeah, it's what it will do. First of all, verse 25, he will speak against the Most High and oppress his holy people and try to change the set time. We are also told here that it will subdue three kings. So as it is growing from the fourth kingdom, it plucks out three kings. Then he will speak against the Most High. He will oppress his people and try to change the times and the laws. So this king or this kingdom, it will change the calendar, to change God's festivals, God's laws, and many other things. So who is this kingdom that will arise? And then its powers will be taken away from him. Here he is, the literal kingdom of the world. So let's look from the Bible prophecy, the four kingdoms. We have Babylon, Persia, Greece, and the last one is Rome. So during the kingdom of Rome, that's where it is described to have 10 horns. And as he was looking, a little horn came up and plucked three horns, leaving seven horns. So these are the 10 kingdoms. Of the 10 kings in Rome. From the first one, Almani, which is known as Germany. Then you have Ugudians, which is the Swiss Australia. France, the modern country is known as French. Then we have the Visigoths, the modern country known as Spanish or Spain. Then you have the Portuguese, the England or British, Britons, Anglo-Saxons. You have heard of the word Anglo, Anglican, etc. Then you have Vandals. This one is part of North Africa. It was destroyed. The other one is Erur. It was formerly part of Italy. It was also destroyed. Then you have Ostrogoths. Was also in Italy, it was destroyed. Then you have the Lombards, so these are the Italian people, they are still there up to date. So those are the 10 kingdoms. Now let's look at what is this little horn that came up and plucked the three. So the three kingdoms that were plucked, you have a rule, then Ostrogoths and Vandals. These three kingdoms were destroyed by the upcoming Papal Rome or papacy led by the Pope. So as you can see, once it plucked only 7 countries to mint. This is evidenced from colonization in Africa. Only 7 countries participated: Italy, Germany, Belgium, Portuguese, Spain, France, and British. From our list here, you can see only those countries listed here took part in the colonization, meaning the prophecy here is very accurate, super accurate on what really happened. So one of the things that we have heard is that the literal on from this Bible verse is that it will change the times and the laws. So from the world history, we know that the Bible calendar has been changed by the Roman Catholic. So this is an example. You have the months listed in the Roman calendar versus what they mean. They named months after planets, after gods. You can see here, for instance, Matthias, January, or Janus, named for god of gates and doors. Then Februaris, the month of... So the Roman Catholic changed so much of the times as prophesied. So here you can look at the Roman calendar versus the biblical calendar. You can see the months in the Bible, and you can also find the Bible verses where you can find these months. So it's listed here, you can see them. Yeah, for instance, the first month is Nisan. Yet, according to the calendar of the Romans, it's known as March or April. Yeah. So you have Iyar or Zif, Zivan, Tammuz, Ab, Elul, Tishra, Bul, Kislev, Shebat, Kislev, Hadal. Those are the months of the Bible, but they have you can find them in these Bible verses. They confirm that indeed these are the months of the Bible, but the Romans changed as prophesied, as the literal on of Daniel. It also introduced Sunday worship, as evidenced in this image. Yeah, they started worshipping the sun on this great Sunday. This was declared by a man called Constantine. He made the first Sunday law in the year 321 AD. So he's saying on this venerable day of the sun, quote, Venerare dies solis, the sacred day of the sun. Let the magistrates and the people residing in the cities rest, and let all the workshops be closed. So this was the first Sunday law. But surprisingly, they allowed people in the Ushago or in the rural areas to go on with their business. So it was a selective thing based on convenience. Yeah, here he says, but to those who are situated in the country freely and at liberty to attend the business of agriculture. So they were allowed to go to work. So you can see this one is very different from what God declares, that people should rest on the Sabbath. Everyone, even the strangers in your land. But here you can see the declaration allowed people to do their work on Sunday, as it is today. Yeah, you find people opening their shops on Saturday, others going on with their business. So it's not Very convenient. Additionally, something that you realize about this is that they changed the laws of God. If you compare the Ten Commandments of God as taught by the Roman Church and as taught in the Bible, they contradict. They remove the Second Commandment that talks about graven images and such, and then they split the Tenth Commandment. So the first one is okay, the second one is not there, the third one now becomes the second, the third becomes the second, the fourth becomes the third, then the tenth becomes the ninth. So they split it into two. Do not covet to your neighbor's wife. That's one of becomes the ninth. And the other one is do not covet on the neighbor's property. So this way they make them to be ten.